Hi everyone. So today I'm going to continue my whole story on my autoimmune diet plan that I'm following. I don't know if you recall, but I'm taking it or going onto it because I've been diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis about 3 weeks ago. My rheumatologist prescribed me some meds. It's in the cupboard. It's waiting for me or not. In the meantime, I'm going to do a 30-day eating plan to see if I can't maybe reduce the inflammation in my body by excluding gluten, eggs, sugar, dairy, caffeine, alcohol, and also a nightshade vegetables. Also legumes, seeds, and nuts. So it's quite a big group of things that I need to avoid. But you know, when you're desperate, dan gaan jy nou enig iets probeer. So, die eerste ding waarmee ek gaan begin is, wat is gluten? What is gluten? Because, you know, it's such a buzzword. People use it and I don't actually also know very much about it, but I'm learning and teaching myself more about it, researching it, trying to get on top of it, trying to understand why is gluten such a buzzword. But the one thing is, gluten is made up of proteins and it is found in many grains. It is found in stuff like wheat, semolina, spelt, rye, and barley. Now, oats is not a grain, but because they manufacture oats in facilities where there's wheat, there's obviously loads of cross-contamination. So one should therefore then also stay away from oats unless it says certified gluten-free oats, which I suppose is going to be very expensive. Then gluten is also considered a sticky protein because it actually holds molecules together. You'll see when you do like bread dough, they always say you need to work it a bit so that the gluten can come activate, which makes it sticky, so it holds very well, and therefore they use it often as a binder and a filler in different products. And it was interesting when I had a look at the list. I'm going to share some of it with you. So the obvious ones we know in breads and grains are, you know, those are all glutens, but stuff like, I'm going to see on my list, alcohol, candy, corn chips, gravy cubes. They also talk about instant or restaurant mashed potatoes. Also the restaurant eggs contains gluten. Vitamins, the vitamin capsules, often they filled, to fill them, they add some gluten. And then vegan meat substitutes have got a lot of gluten in. And then baking powder and all kinds of artificial flavorings. All of that contains a lot of gluten, which we don't always are aware of. And then what you don't know is that at the back of your packaging, if you read it, you'll find words like hydrolyzed vegetable proteins. That is a hidden name for gluten. Stuff like vegetable proteins or even natural flavors. Or food starches, those things are all hidden gluten added into products that we don't even know about if we don't read the labels. Then the other question that we often ask is, but it doesn't make sense, you know. My grandma and my grandfather, they always used to eat gluten, and how come it's now become such a buzzword? But what we forget is that there's been a lot of hybridization with the gluten molecule over the decades. And the reason why they've hybridized it so much is so that it can withstand bad weather, the crops can grow faster, the turnaround time can be quicker. And the other thing that they've also done is they've done deamination of the gluten molecule, which means they've taken the gluten molecule so that it can make stuff bigger and fluffier. And you know, when you see stuff made with some of the Gluten products, they are huge, and all these things, the deamination process then makes the gluten molecule water soluble. Nou 'n wateroplosbare glutenmolekuule word dan gebruik vir goed waarin jy nou goed dik mee maak en en te preserveer. So gluten becomes a preservative and a filler when it's been through a deamination process, and the deamination process then makes every gluten like an omnipresent thing in everything and anywhere that you look, and all labels that you read are just hidden gluten all over. So we also forget that animals get fed with lots of grains. So now you're eating grain-fed meat. You're eating grains all the time. Grain is found in all kinds of fast food and quick and easy stuff that you buy in sauces. So you are consuming more gluten than you actually want to. And then the other thing that's important about gluten is that gluten contains an enzyme called zonulin. Zonulin is responsible to keep your epithelial cells, which lines your gut, nice and tight together like pavers. Now, if you are like me, in an autoimmune situation where I am now in a high inflammatory situation with my rheumatoid arthritis, and I consume gluten, then what it does is it creates little gaps between your epithelial lining in your gut. Your pavers open up, and partially digested food start moving through there, and that moves into your bloodstream. Now, anything foreign that moves into your bloodstream make your body go into high alert, because now suddenly your body picks up foreign stuff and it wants to produce antibodies against it. It wants to kill it. It wants to get rid of it. It wants to make sure that it doesn't inflame or cause illness. And that whole process of your body reacting to this foreign subject causes inflammation. So the more gluten you consume, the more gaps you create between your epithelial layers and your gut, and that thing is known as a leaky gut, which now also needs to get restored if you consume a lot of gluten. So for today, we're only talking about why we should avoid gluten, or especially when you've got an autoimmune disease like me. But if you're a normal person, then I suppose you would take gluten in a moderate manner. En eet nie net heeldag koek en taart en koekies en beskuit en brood en braaibroodjies tot die wees op die wolke aankom nie, want dit is ook nie goed vir jou liggaam nie, al is jy 'n gesonde persoon. Gluten veroorsaak ook goed soos IBS, baie mense voel sleg, hulle diarree, en dit alles net van 'n klein ou dingetjie met die naam gluten. Ook aan julle liefde.